This is Jameson with Cooper Fleet Services. Today is April 8th, 2022, and this is recent automotive news. Yesterday, Elon Musk, clad in a cowboy hat and sunglasses, delivered the first batch of Model Ys out of his new Giga Factory in Austin, Texas. This makes Tesla's sixth giant auto manufacturing plant that spans now three continents. The Austin factory is now the world headquarters for Tesla, and a projected 500,000 Model Y crossovers are planned for production at the plant before the introduction of the Cybertruck, scheduled for October of 2023. During the factory launch event, Elon titled the Cyber Rodeo, he announced plans to roll out a 100% autonomous driving taxi. Musk said, quote, "There's going to be a dedicated robo-taxi that's going to look quite futuristic." No timelines were given on this and other projects like the next generation Roadster or Tesla's semi-truck, but Elon noted that the focus in 2023 is going to be more focused on the product, after this year's focus being production volume. There were also a lot of rumors circulating that Tesla will offer a large commercial van sometime in 2024, pending the results of the Cybertruck launch. This would be very interesting, as several companies are already competing for the future of last mile delivery vehicles. I have no doubt that Tesla entering the market will provide even more healthy competition in the space, hopefully leading to even better products for the end users. Russia's invasion of Ukraine is still going strong, with global tensions continuing to rise and manufacturers experiencing disruptions from this conflict. We expect that the vehicle shortage will continue. Although US auto manufacturers are mostly keeping quiet, the signs of supply chain problems are still front and center when you look at dealerships' inventories. Levels are at the lowest I've seen in my 12-year career and expect it to get worse. Chevrolet seems to be doing the best out of the big three US auto manufacturers. Usually at Cooper Fleet, we have about a perfect 50-50 split between Chevy and Ford sales, but so far the first quarter of 2022 is more like 95-5 in favor of Chevrolet. We've had just about equal number of Ford and Chevrolets on order currently, but it seems that Chevrolet is actually delivering sold units to us at a rate almost 20-1 of Ford. Although Ford isn't admitting it, I think that their focus on future production and the EV revolution is making them forsake today and the needs of their customers right now. I definitely love progress in the industry, but I have a hard time getting behind it at the sake of the world's current needs. Toyota is lowering the production forecast of 2022 to 1.5 million units, stating that the supply chain issues were to blame. This is more than a 6% decrease from their projections not long ago. They also hinted that further adjustments may be needed depending on many factors, the biggest being the supply of semiconductors. Bob Carter, the head of Toyota's North American sales, said that the fourth quarter would be, quote, murky, and that factors may even bring their yearly productions below 15 million units. But it seems to be too early to tell at this point. So much for the talking points they were giving us last year, stating that by the end of 2022, the market would start to see some sense of normalcy back. Glad I didn't hold my breath. That's been it for automotive news this week. If you like content like this, feel free to check out our website at www.cooperfleetservices.com. Liking and subscribing greatly helps us out. Really appreciate everyone that's already done that. If you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section down below. Hope everyone enjoys the rest of their Friday and has a great weekend. We'll see you next week. Thanks.